Friends, welcome to a yet another information security news episode. Let's go into the first news. First news is centered around India, wherein the ruling party for India, which is Bharatiya Janata Party's website, got hacked, and it's been over 24 hours and their website is still to come up and it's still under maintenance mode. So cyber attacks are real and it can happen to anyone. The moral of the story is to stay vigilant and invest in cyber security to stay safe, as per this particular link. The next one is with respect to German police are storing the body cam worn by their police officers onto Amazon servers located inside Germany. So they say that Amazon servers has the capacity to be able to take in that much of data, and the data which they put into their servers are encrypted before storing it there. There are some sectors of people who call that Amazon is selling facial recognition software to US police, and we shouldn't get ourselves tainted with that, something of that particular sort. So some people are against to this particular idea. So if you want to read more news about this particular thing, go to this particular link, and the links are also linked in the show description below. The next one is with respect to IoT automation servers are exposed to internet, is what's being found via Shodan. So Shodan discovered that a lot of home automation devices made by Home Assistant, Home Hub, are available out on the internet, around like 15,000 devices just from one variety. So as soon as a vulnerability of some sort is discovered in that, attackers would try to leverage them and try to take over this particular system. The additional thing which they could do is they could start controlling your devices inside your home. Trend Micro also says that if the number of devices, IoT devices in your house crosses 10, then they classify it as a CIE, which stands for complex IoT environment. And in order to prevent such things from happening and to secure these IoT devices, the first thing is to start from the automation server. And the one more thing which they say is that these automation servers do not give an alert if the rules logic in them is changed. So as user, you need to often like log into your system to see if the logic has been changed. So on to the next one, which is Qt IT. It's a Python based program which can convert malicious IP into several different forms, which looks cute, but it is going to offer the same level of sting. What this can do is it can throw off regex related domain catching and IP catching scripts which can run against your log. So this is a way of actually bypassing your security mechanism. So you just need to be aware of such tools existing in the market. The next one is with respect to APT40, which is related with China Nexus espionage actor. These people were previously called by the term of Temp Periscope and Temp Jumper by FireEye. So this APT threat group mainly targets maritime transport. It's also said that these people acquired underwater unmanned underwater vehicle of US which was roaming in the South China Sea, something like that, and because of which they were able to gain some technological advantage in the naval space, is what is being claimed in the FireEye report. In addition to that, there are a number of tools which this particular APT group uses, which for each and every phase, like for the initial compromise or foothold or escalating the privilege, going on to recon, pilfering around the network, maintaining access and completing the mission by taking whatever data which is there in the organization, jumping it across several different servers inside their own organization, finally moving it on to one server where they use rar.exe to zip them up, compress them and then exfiltrate the data out. So there are several funny names which FireEye has given to the tools which this APT40 users have threat actor 40 has used. Another notable thing is like they usually rely on web shells for initial foothold. So secure your web space as well as they also use phishing related campaigns is what is being reported in this particular link. So stay safe. The next one is with respect to the Docker related vulnerability which I spoke about. There are still around like 3000 to 4000 machines out on the internet running vulnerable version of Docker. This vulnerability allows the attacker to bypass the container and overwrite the run C binary on the host machine and also execute it. And after executing it, they try to download malware which is used for cryptojacking and mining Monero currency on that particular infrastructure. The last news of today is with respect to thousands of Israeli websites got defaced because the DNS record for a particular tool called particular web plugin, actually Nagachi, was poisoned. What this attack failed to do is it also had a second component of trying to download ransomware, but it did not succeed because of coding issues, coding errors made by the attackers. So with this, we come to the end of today's security newscast. Thanks a lot for watching this video. Bye bye.